Good morning, everybody. It's 11 a.m. at our time in Paris, and I'm in Cannes, and it's a good pleasure for me to present this webinar. And we'll talk first around the mesotherapy, and then with fillers, and like that, you will have an idea and all the combination we can use in our technique of beauty. And I think both techniques must be used together to be very satisfying on that way, okay? So Swissel, as I told you, it's a laboratory from Swiss, and it's a very well done one. And the goal we have to expect is to a highest quality and the strictest safety standards, which means with all our range of products, we can be very safe and be comfortable to use them as well and to get a good using for each product by itself. We have a range of dermal filler, which is a Forte, Normal and Hydro. And also a patented formula of CHAT technology with H line, meso skin line, and also a range for airline. So with all this kind of product, we can be allowed, you know, to use all the range and to be very efficient in our procedure. Which means all our product makes a new generation of balance and a good CHAT complex for the reconstructive stimulation the mesotherapy. For that, what we are expecting is a good reflection of our light and to get, you know, a very good smoothing, good quality, good hydration of the skin. And this patented CHAT technology is very interesting. It's why I use this product since a couple of times, because it was very, very efficient, and I did appreciate a lot all this technique. Usually you can use few sessions, but I will give you all the dates and everything about that. Okay, what we are maintaining and we wanted to do is to work in a non-invasive solution for skin, even hair area. We fight against aging, aesthetic issues to get them, and hair loss. We are working over the ptosis as well, the wrinkles, the dryness of the skin, and I repeat all the time, when you have a good hydration of the skin, a good firmness of the skin, you will be more successful in your injection, and you will be able to combine with all other techniques, and it's very interesting for us. Aesthetic issues as well, we fight against hyperpigmentation, telangiectasis, acne, scars, and puffiness as well. And for hair loss, alopecia, graying, loss hair, of course, seborrhea, and it's interesting because adding all these products together, we have a good target and Google calls, you know, because it's a non-systemic effect, a good ingredient, active ingredient, non-invasive as well. We have a good prevention of the skin and the quality as well. You can combine the technique with fillers, lasers, pills, and also surgery. And also the amount and the cost can be very interesting. When we talk about, you know, aging of the skin, we lose a lot of amount, you know, a big amount of water, which means that the moisture regulation must be involved, you know, with the quality of the product, and we must nourish the collagen as well. And the patented CHAT products for that are very efficient. It's the number one in innovation, and that it made me very confident for that. And this CHAT technique, the name is cross-linked hyaluronic acid composition, which means you will have a matrix of HA, and then adult with that, shaking with that, we have different components, and I will explain how it's working. And we want to make a formation of crosslinks between linear molecules of HA to increase, you know, the duration and the effect of this HA in the skin. And very interesting for that, which means that we have essential nutrition, we want to get an effective delivery of all the components, and we minimize the degradation of the product to a long lasting of the efficacy, which meant a very long lasting result. Okay, this phase, as I told you, we have first a matrix of HA, combining in a second way with the cross-linking complex, which are formed, you know, with the integrating active ingredients. And it's a way, you know, to stimulate the production of the collagen as well. And we can see this result in 3D dimension molecular complex, which is formed as well. The mechanical reaction for that, you combine HA with vitamins, peptide, microelements, amino acid, and you have a pressure, a compressor for all these components together around, you know, this matrix, which makes, you know, this JAK patented formula, and we are very efficient and proud to show it with our laboratory, because we deliver a high bioavailability of the components, and it's important, you know, to get a good safety, reinforcement of the skin barrier. We activate, you know, all the mechanisms of regeneration of the tissue, and we have also a good accumulation of the bioactive element, which makes, you know, a good protection for our skin. What are the benefits we are to expect for? It's protecting ingredients from hyaluronidase, the natural one we have under our skin. It's increasing, you know, the bioavailability of the active ingredients. We optimally distribute active ingredients to boost efficacy and to stimulate this collagen synthesis, and a unique priority method to have a good stabilization of the product. For that, two range for that, skin line and age line. I start with the skin line, and this one is more, you know, interesting to use it when you want to fight against aging and sun damages. And with all the factors we can have from tobacco, sun, stress, and all these kind of factors. And this product combined for HA, so hyaluronic acid, combining with peptide, amino acid, hyaluronic vitamin, and I will tell you the different solution and what all the product brings its own capability of being efficient. Acid hyaluronic brings elasticity as well, and you have a more good moisturizing of the epidermis. When you use amino acid, you can see we don't have so much proline, lysine, glycine, valine, and cysteine. And this one blocks, you know, the repair collagen. So it's a necessary supplement we can have on the skin on to fight against aging. About the peptide, you know, we have the production of the collagen by itself. And you will see glutathione, dipeptide, pamitoglyp, and pamitoyl tripeptide. They are very interesting because each component has its own importance, very important, combined with vitamin C and biotin. And it's important whenever it's a vitamin C, you can use it in the morning, in the evening. After, with the question, you can ask, and you will be very welcome, and I will answer all your question. Okay, about, you know, all these peptides and so on, the action we want to expect and to look for, to fight for against is antioxidanting, anti-inflammatory process, very important, and also to work on pigmentation, but skin line will be more interesting, age line will be more interesting for that. Okay, vitamin C stimulates the synthesis of the collagen as well. And it's very important because we also protect the skin pigmentation, and it acts of antioxidant action. And we have also a good drainage, you know, of the lymphatic system. So we are very complete in our treatment, in our goal, you know, to be satisfied for that. And we can use it for photoaging, wrinkles, cupros as well, fun lines, hyperpigmentation. When I say hyperpigmentation, quite often, it's for melasma, especially in my country, because I'm living in south of France. Dehydrated skin as well. Also visible dryness. And when you have a very sensitive skin, it's very interesting to stimulate, you know, this tissue to get a good density of the product as well. So the program is the best way. Usually when I'm making a program, I'm making three injection, 3 weeks interval, and usually I do that twice a year. And it's enough, usually it's very important. A couple of years ago, when we were talking and working about mesotherapy, we had to repeat our session every month all the time, and it was not so easy. So with the program, I repeat, 3 session, 3 weeks interval, and you can repeat after, it's according with the patient. Sometimes we can target more treatment, but usually it's very interesting for that. I like to make the skin line first to prepare the skin, and then I can combine with my other techniques. So what we expect is a good regeneration of the tissue. We want to look younger and longer efficacy for the product, a reflection of the light, which means a glowing effect, and it's very quick and we have an instant result. About the hyperpigmentation, fine lines, aging, skin hydration, we have a directly, you know, an action and a good effect for that. And we have an improvement and a good synthesis of our collagen. To give you an idea, we have a slide here to show you before and after on a periorbital zone, how we can use on a 3D, even 4D now. And we are more efficient to see how the tissue can be very repaired. Okay, another example here for acne scarring, for example. And you can repeat 3 sessions, but already after 1 session, you can start to see a good result, and it's very interesting for that. Skin line can be combined also with edge line. I like it very much because we are working on an anti-aging treatment. We reduce the wrinkles, skin laxity. So when you want to combine hyperpigmentation correction and anti-aging treatment, you can make a balance between edge line and skin line. And usually I make 1 session first skin line, then edge line, and I make a balance of an alternance of this product. You can notice it's the same way, same Chak pentatic formula, which means this matrix of a J, combining with amino acid, hyaluronic acid as well as a matrix, vitamins, and peptide. There's a small difference, you know, between the product as well. And you can see it's almost very, very familiar. We have more vitamins on edge line, but it's very similar. It's approaching, you know, it's why I like to combine both. What we expect, you know, is of course to create a good density, trophicity, elasticity of the skin, a good moisturizing with the amino acid, and a good synthesis, you know, of all the collagen. The peptide as well to stimulate the cell activity, the microcircularization properties as well. And also, you know, we protect all the factors, pollution and all the factors that damage the skin as well. And you can see whenever we have also the vitamin C, like on the skin line, we have tocophenol and riboflavin and biotin, which are very interesting. And all these components, you know, shaking together, compact together around this matrix of HA are very efficient. And you can see the same effect. We talk about when we have edge line, Botox in a jar, which means whenever I'm not using toxin, I make a lot of injection above, you know, the eyebrow, for example, here. And with a cannula, I can slide with my cannula over the eyebrow, under my skin over here. And after, I can spread the product as well. You have a good capacity, you know, of spreading the product. And it's very interesting because we can get a long-lasting, a good result, a good elasticity of the product as well. And we have also a production, of course, of the collagen and the elastin. So it makes a good tropicity of the product, and I like that very much. And we also get, you know, a good lymphatic drainage. I think it's very clear. You can understand. After with the question, if you need some more information, I will be here for answering. You know, what we expect, in fact, with all our product, whatever it can be, edge line or skin line, we want to get a stimulation of the collagen as well with the amino acid. Arginine is one of the best components we can have for hydration of the skin as well. You know, the stimulation of the cell activity will be done by the peptide as well. It's a resume, and I wanted to show you on this slide, you know, how we can combine all these components, shaking with HA to get a good providency to be very efficient. And we also, with the vitamin C, fight against inflammatory and aggressive and invasive procedure. Vitamin B1 to B6, vitamin E, vitamin C, and as I told you before, you can use it morning, evening, whatever you want. It's not a problem. We can be very efficient. As we work on hyperpigmentation with skin line and so on, here in such case, we work more on a dryness, lack of firmness and total wrinkles and fine line, the lack of skin regency, and as I told you, when you speak about mesotherapy, I prefer to talk about light feeling, reflection of the light, and after Cuprose. If you work with Cuprose, sometimes I like to work with my colleague dermatologist. It's interesting to combine sometimes with laser. Okay, the protocol, same way for edge line, it's a 3 to 6 procedure. You can make 1 or 2 sessions in a week, but 3 sessions, 3 weeks interval, twice a year is very efficacy. Okay, so the result, as I told you, we have, you know, a prevention for wrinkles, the fine line, the sign of aging, and we improve the lifting, you know, effect, firmness, skin complexion, radiancy of the light. So we are very competitive, you know, to get a very good success. Okay. Of course, to get, you know, an according with all our products, we have to prove scientifically, you know, this efficacy. And we make different studies, you know, after mesotherapy and on different volunteers. And what I wanted to show you, I was very critical of that. We have around 25 to 50 patients for testing that. The age will be around 50 years old. And we have to make the same procedure to inject the same area and to get, you know, the result with 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and to be very efficacy for that. And we have to analyze, you know, the density increased, you know, with the treatment. And you can notice that already after 90 days, 3 months, you have always still a good efficacy of the product. It proved a good hydration and a good stimulation of the collagen as well. And so remember, good density of the skin. That it's absolutely interesting that we can give a big amount of products whenever it's already 3 months. It's why I like this kind of protocols to repeat pre-session 3 weeks interval. Okay. As I told you with density, we have also a radiancy improvement. And you can see also after 3 months, we conserve and we still have a good stimulation of the product, the tissue. And you know, we have a good evaluation of that. We can work in 3D, especially photography, and we can be very satisfied with product. And I do appreciate them. It's why I like to combine, I repeat, edge line and skin line usually as much as we can. Two procedures as well, I can show you that here we choose especially patients with no other treatment, only mesotherapy, which means that after we can combine with filler, we can combine with other techniques. But what we wanted to show you that I did not choose a young patient because it's important, you know, to show how we can be very efficace, you know, on all kinds of ethnic, all kinds of phototypes, and we can be very effective of, for that. Okay, after two procedures. Usually what we're expecting is to inject in a very safety way, you know, important to get a good satisfaction of the patient, but also of our satisfaction as we are experimented and expert on this kind of treatment. And since I'm using, you know, Apraline range, I'm very, very happy for that. And we have a very significant improvement for the product. And we have each session gives a plus, and we make very big progress, and we correct the skin more and more. For using the product, we have two opportunities. We can make injection, we can make microneedling. Microneedling, I used it a lot a couple of years ago, and I forget it at all. And since I know this product from Apraline, I came back to microneedling. What I was doing, I was cleaning my skin, that I think as you are doing, all of you, is based on the clear skin type and condition, so we can respect all phototypes, as I told you. You apply a spread anesthetic if you want. I'm a surgeon, so I don't use it so much, I can tell you. Anyway, you can choose. But it's not very aggressive, not too much invasive. So usually people like, and I think it's okay. You clean the skin with an antiseptic as well. You fill up your syringe, you know, and you choose the complex according with the treatment areas and the areas you expect to correct as well. You have already a vial of 5 cc, and that you know how we can fill up the syringe that I pass very quickly. We have to stimulate deeper penetration, and microneedling for that is very interesting. What I'm doing, I make one first passage only with the roller without product. So I'm creating small tunnelization of the product. I can make it on the full face, the neck, the cleavage. So it's very interesting for that. You make between 4 to 6 passages in multi-direction, in cross-etching technique. You create these micro channels, and with that, it's interesting, and you start to have, you know, a boosting of the skin and a thickness aspect. It must not bleed too much, because sometimes you have people who are very aggressive, they plant the roller, they are too much invasive, and if it's bleeding too much, I don't agree with that. So, thickness effect, and you adjust the needle. Usually the deepness of the rollers I'm using, it will be 1 millimeter to 1.5, and I think it's very interesting. 0.8 is more for aesthetician and so on, and we must be very careful for that. But for our doctors and you and I, it's very interesting to use 1.5, I think it's the best way. Okay? You repeat the session, as I told you, three sessions, 3 weeks interval. So I told you, I make first my first passage with without product. Then I put my drops of skin line or edge line as well. I make the massage. I spread the products everywhere like that as well. Second passage is with the product. Third passage, I use again my roller and I make new cross-etching on all the areas I want to correct. Then I make a second adding, you know, of a product, edge line or skin line, and I make the massage to make it penetrate. And then I repeat that 3 times. Usually it's very interesting. When you make a maintain for that, well, it's according with the patient for the best treatment. I think every 3 months it sounds very good. And after, you have to give them the advice to conserve, you know, a home care and other treatment. And during about, I can say, 1 day, extreme temperature, sauna, hammam, exposition on UV, gymnastic, makeup, as much as you can, applying product on the skin. And it's very interesting, but that is a concern we can give to all our patients, for all our technique, whenever it's meso, whenever it's fillers, though it's not a problem, it's very similar for all the techniques. We have few contraindications for the protocol, and it's absolutely contraindicated, you know, to when you have a really damaged scar tissue, streptococcal infection, skin alteration, cortical therapy, but sometimes I could use it, I tell you, immunosuppressant treatment, acute joint rheumatics, repetitive angina, endocarditis. That it's absolutely contraindication. We must avoid any treatment because if you want to, we work in beauty, we want to be very safe, and I think it's not good to talk about that, okay? Relative contraindication can be for diabetic people, anticoagulation, autoimmune disease. But believe me, I also have some patients with anticoagulation. I explain to them that they can bleed a little more, but I don't quit their treatment because we have to be safe and first their health and then beauty. I think it's important for us. Complication we can have is very exceptional. Attached wood I did not have, but we can have infection with local treatment, with antiseptics and antibiotic treatment to avoid it as well. If you have an inflammation, you can use corticotherapy. If you have a small pain, I use ice. quite often and painkillers whenever it's necessary, but not so much. You can sometimes have HA complication with granulomas as well, some kystis and so on. So in such case, we can use hyaluronidase. In my practice, I can tell you that hyaluronidase, I used it 4 times in my 30 years practice. So you can see that normally hyaluronidase must not be used only in dangers. And the time I used them, one was with one of my patients, but the other was for the injection of other colleagues. So you can realize that hyaluronidase can be an opportunity to correct. Even now, when you are in Congress, people say, you have a problem, you use hyaluronidase. Okay, you use it, but be very careful, don't use too much. And if we make a good job and we make good injection, we are very safe in the first step, I think it's much better. How can I resume, you know, on microneedling protocols? When I combine skin large or headline and sometimes both, what I'm expecting is a good regeneration. And in such case, I can make a balance with the two products because skin line will be more for hyperpigmentation, anti-age prevention, skin exudation. So skin line is better for that. And we want to have a more damaged skin if we lose bad density, elasticity or tropicity. In such case, age line is used to combine. So usually, I sincerely mix both skin line and edge line, and I repeat this session as well. Okay? As we can combine the technique, it's very easy because I work also with our colleagues and maybe you dermatologists, lasers as well. So you apply another session or 1 week interval or 2 weeks as well. And LED light treatments, same way, before the session, you can make a LED session and then you proceed to meso, it's very interesting, for the peeling as well. I prefer first to make my peeling with preparation of the skin with a glycolic acid or a TCA. Usually it will be between 12 to 18%. Biorevitalization is important, and in such case, I'm using a non-cross-linking product which is Aperline Hydro. I will talk it about after. Very interesting for that. And for surgery, I give the advice to all our colleagues who are surgeons, when they make a blepharoplasty, facelift and everything, contouring injection and so on, but especially for surgery, it's very good to make one session before the surgery and 2 or 3 sessions repeated after the procedure. And it's very interesting because we get a better smoothness, better cicatrization, better comfort for the patient, better hemostasis as we are operating. So we save time, comfort of the patient, and we are very more efficacious. Okay? Combined technique, as I told you, it's to get a biorevitalization, which means I use skin and edge line, and I combine with upper line hydro. And I think it's a program who fights against all the pigmentation and all the aging problems. And I like to combine. This hydro, it's 18 milligrams containing of HA. It can be injected as well. You can use it in microneedling also, whatever you want. You can use and repeat the session, pre-session, 3 weeks interval. The long lasting can be around 6 months. I can tell you that. 3 months, also you can see with the results and the studies we made that we still have a lot of products still efficacious on our tissue after 3 months. So I can say that long lasting might be around 6 months. And very interesting because with this hydro, we can get a good radiancy of the skin. Because sometimes, whenever you use a filler or something else, when you want to get a lightening effect, I make a more superficial injection, always a cannula, always needles, more superficially under the tissue, and you get a good radiancy of the product. You can work also on the face, full face, neck, cleavage as well, back of hands, upper arm. You can work on all the parts of your body, and it's very comfortable for the patient. Okay. Duration, you know, and capability means that with long-lasting result will be approved, you know, with fillers, but Aqualine Hydro is already efficace, as I told you, around 3 to 6 months. The technique for glomerular revitalization as well, I wrote papula injection, micro papula. I prefer to tell micro bolus of 0.05 each. And it's very interesting because like that, we can be very superficial, efficace, and the people, the patient, don't leave the office and the clinic with a lot of papula and blonding effect. So it's more comfortable and sometimes we appreciate that. The bleaching technique, it's more for the cold bar over the lips over here. You must be very superficial, 10 degrees inclination for that. And you have to see this bleaching of the skin and it stay, you know, a couple of minutes, you know, before disappearing. And it's very interesting also to do that, especially to fight against the small features we can have over the lips, okay? How we can combine hydro and mesotherapy, usually, as I told you, it's a 3 sessions, 3 weeks interval. I'm using 1 vial of age or skin line, or sometimes both, and 1 cc of hydro. And it's very interesting because I make micromeddling with my skin and my line, and I make injection, always cannula, always a needle, of my hydro. Like that, it's a very efficace, you know, because we work in different levels and the penetration of the skin, and it's very good for to give you an idea of that. Here, to show you, it's exactly the same light, same position, with 1 session, you can notice at once as the déplissé can disappear, and we can have a good reflection of the light. And I like very much this slide, because it shows you that we are already natural effect and very quick effect, instant effect. So I think it's interesting to show you that. That was for age line, skin line, hydro as well. I try to be quick as much as I can. On meso, we have also Aqualine Airline, which is very interesting. Why? Because we can use it for alopecia treatment as well. Also combining with surgery and graft, hair graft. And it's good for that. Same procedure, patented technique of Chak technique, and we prevent, you know, hair loss. It's stimulating, you know, the growth of the hair, and we have a better condition. We get a good, our goal is to improve the condition of the scalp, and we get hyaluronic acid as well, peptide, vitamin, amino acid, as all the other products of Aqualine's range, and micro elements, okay? How it works? We have a promotion growth, you know, and stimulation of the collagen as well. And we have a good drainage of all the connective tissue. We have a reinforce of the skin barrier as well. We have an anti-catabolic effect. We get, you know, a good recovering and a good moisturizing of the skin on the scalp as well. And you have a good stabilization and good hydration and stimulation of the protein on with the arginine. The combining micro element as well is the zinc and the copper, which are found in other products, in other laboratories, and is very efficace for that. And you can combine also with biotin, cysteine injection in intramuscular, and very good for that. So action, you know, for anti-inflammatory inflammation, antioxidant action, good mineral formation of the tissue, and we fight again, you know, the seborrhea and all, you know, the defect we can have on the scalp. Okay, the indication as well, as I told you, diffuse alopecia, different areas. Sometimes it's very special, and especially Arabic ladies when they wear a veil. Sometimes they have different parts of the scalp. Men are more, you know, losing their hair on the scalp over here. It's different, it's up to sex, and according with the way of life and the ethnic and the country where you live, okay? damaged air shaft, as I told you, is a fragility, because some people have a hair more fragile as well because of the way of their life, the how they can live, you know, the comfort and the products they can use, because people are not equal in front of beauty. And it's a pity for that, but we have no choice. We have to adapt the treatment for that, okay? Fighting against the seborrhea, early graying of hair, because it can be genetic problem also. And we have to manage and to combine the treatment for that, okay? The protocol, you can make one procedure, one or two procedure in 1 week. You can combine 6 to 8 sessions, and you can repeat this program as well. Very interesting, and we can combine as well. The indication for using, as I told you, diffuse alopecia, different area, seborrhea, graying, early graying as well, androgenic alopecia, non-cicatricial alopecia. On cicatrices, on scars, it doesn't work. Okay, patient preparation, we ask them to wash and dry the hair the same day as the procedure, and no add any spray or waxing product or fixing product over it. They came with a natural hair by the treatment as well. We have a vial of 5 cc and we inject, I said 0.5 millimeter deep. It can be until 2 millimeters. It's a microneedling technique. Usually I let the rule of the two, because I make every point, every 2 millimeter deep, and I make band every 2 centimeters. So it helps very easy, and it can be very interesting to use as well, okay? And the two or three first session can be a little more painful, because sometimes the galea is fixed, but after a treatment, when it's more comfortable, the galea is more moving and it's more comfortable for the patient. And we can use different layers for injection. Maintenance and home care as well. For males, I make one session biweekly and I maintain one every 2 months after. For females, I make one session weekly, but I repeat more sessions, usually 8. More often 8 than 6, and I maintain the session also every 2 months. Same way, as I told for hand care, they must clean the air 24 after treatment, and they avoid also, as I told you for other procedure, extreme temperature, sauna, hammer, all product who can, all activities who can give sedation, and I think it's better to say that, okay? Sometimes you can have a small hematoma or edema, but it's very exceptional, as I told you. As for the other product in mesotherapy, absolute contraindication, they are the same one, and I think we must be very strict for that and must be very careful for that. Relatives contraindication as well, diabetics, anticoagulation, dandruff, permanent hair implants, and autoimmune disease, but we can use as well, and it works also very well. So I repeat, airline, 2 weekly sessions before grafting, 6-8 weekly sessions after grafting, and starting 1 month after surgery to improve result. And it's very interesting because it works very well for that. Okay? I control the time. I think we are in a good time. Okay? The result, we prevent hair loss. We reinforce, you know, the hair follicles, and we stimulate the hair growth. We have a good hair quality and better density, smoothness, and softness, and radiancy of the hair, as well. We fight against a premature graying, and we have a good sebo regulation. Procedure, as I told you, we have a reinforcement, you know, of the follicle as well. And you can see it's very interesting to see this result as well. And we reinforce, you know, the statue of the follicle. Okay. As I told you, injection 2 millimeter and distance 2 millimeter as well. With a needle, I use a small needle of, 12 millimeters and 27 or 30 gauges, and it's very good and enough. That result to give you an idea that there are two brothers and you still have, you know, some small hair, because the treatment can be interesting if we still have some more small hair. And you can see after 6 procedures that we can be very efficient. That was his brother, and you can see we are also very efficace, and we can be with the 6 procedure to be very satisfying. Okay, that is very interesting. And for the hair, we have to know that you can make one session before the hair graft, 2 weeks before, and after you make the graft, you wait for 1 month and you continue the procedure. Very interesting. That was for the mesotherapy. I think it's better to finish everything, and after we talk about questions. About apparent fillers, I like them very much, and it's very interesting. We don't have a lot of them, but we have one hydro will be combining in regeneration and skin booster for the collagen as well. And we have normal and Forte product. Okay, the key advantages, you know, for our product, it's a monophasic homogeneous cross-linking product. It's a good gel with a good elasticity, good viscosity as well, a high level of elasticity and viscosity. Important, we have a good stability of the product. We have less than 4% of EBDA. You have a force of injection which is very easy, so maximum safety for injecting as well, non-animal origin of course, and you can see that we have with this product all the qualities we are expected for being safe in our procedure. Okay, the technique, you know, check for meso and 100% effective cross-linking and amplification of hyaluronic acid for our fillers. As I told you, we have two fillers, Apraline Forte and Apraline, you know, normal. The Forte, I'm using a lot, very interesting for that. They have a long lasting as well. It can be between around 8 months to 12 months. You can correct severe wrinkles and folds as well. You can work on all the full face. And you will notice that with my injection, the last part I'm injecting now with my technique is the nasolabial fold, because I work in a full face and it's very interesting to use them as well. Apparent Forte contains 23 millimeters per milliliter at a high viscosity of the product. You can use it deep contact with the bone. Every time you have a high concentration, you have to inject it contact with the bone, with the cannula, with the needle as well. And you can repeat, usually you can make until one or two syringes. Usually I make one syringe on this hemiface, and it's very interesting. You can work on cheeks, nasolabial fold, marionette lines, marionette folds as well, chin, facial depression. And I also like to make on male, especially angle of mandibular. It's very easy to use, extremely comfortable for the patient, not painful as well. You also have a range, Apraline Forte, one with lidocaine, one without, so you can choose your weight as well. And Apraline Normal. Normal will be injected a little more superficially. This one is more for glabella, crossfit, lips, and all the contour, and I like, you know, to combine all these products as well. The dynamic viscosity and the molecular weight is much lighter for the normal. You can use it and inject it more superficially. It contains 23 millimeters or so. The long lasting will be almost between 8 months as well. And, you know, we correct very easily for that example. Shadows in the angle of the noise, in front part, you know, of the cantus, internal cantus of the periorbital zone. So it's good. For the glabella, it's good also. And one point very important, when I'm injecting glabella, I always inject from the top to down to be very safe. I will talk about special facilities and opportunities, how to use them, of course. As I told you, both available with the lidocaine as well. And you can see on the box in such case, the lidocaine added 0.3% as well. I repeat once more, because I like to combine also for the lighting effect, 18 milligrams, high, the wave molecular weight is much lighter. It's a non-cross-linking in such case, and the long-lasting will be between 3 to 6 months. And you can combine, you know, always meso, always your filler as well. Very interesting for the face, neck, cleavage, back end, upper arms, and you can use it without risk and progress. That was for the range. Now, what I want to tell you, if you want to use all this technique, of course, it's interesting to speak about the product, but it's also important to get, you know, a good knowledge about the anatomical place. For lifting effect as well, how much and which technique you can use as well. Tip and tricks for our face, and I will tell you explain for chin and jaw line as well. Different techniques we can use, or we can use our own needles, and how we can prevent and manage dermal filler complications. That, I think, is the most important part when you know the product, to be very safe and to be sure how we can use as well. So, manageable reminders. Very important to remind and to know that whenever we are working on tissue, the architecture of the patient is very important. We have to respect first if it's a male or a female, if it's the quality of the bone as well, because as we have an aging of the face, it starts, you know, with the lysis of the bone. And we have a decreasing, you know, of the maxilla, the mandibular, not so much because it's the one who keeps, you know, a good size. Lacrimal, the sphenoid bone and all the parts of the bone must be respected as well, the sutures as well, the age and, you know, the quality and the ethnic as well. If you have a square face, you stay in a square treatment. If you have a face triangular, you respect this way. If you want a round one, a circle, and to respect an oval, it's very important to adapt the treatment according with the anatomy. What I was expecting, you know, the meniscus is more blocky and massive, it's more square, so it's very important to adapt the treatment, you know, with the sex, and to see exactly if it's more square, round, and we have to adapt and to consider the injection on face, also on profile, and we can see that we have a bone mass of bone, you know, which is more important on male, and the arch is larger and it's more pronounced. Okay. Of course, when we spoke, we have finished to spoke with the bone, we have to respect, you know, all the muscle, and whenever we are not surgeon, you must know this muscle, you must know the localization, you must know their function, how we can be injected, the local place, and what their function, if they are elevating, they are lowering, you know, it's very important to know, you know, all the function and the position and the agonist and antagonist muscle, and to adapt also your treatment. Especially for frontalis, sometimes I combine quite often with toxin. If I'm using toxin, I make my session first of toxin, I wait for 10 days, and then I work with my fillers. Okay? So we respect the muscle as well. We have a lot of studies. Here it's a slide from a doctor from Sicilia, which is plastic surgeon, and it's a fantastic way of dissection. And you can see how it works, and you can respect also all the vascularization as well, the facial artery, the temporal artery, the supratrochlear artery over here, very important, temporal, facial over here, supralabial artery, inferior labial artery. It's very important, you know, to know all these parts of vascularization and muscle. And if you don't know that, you cannot inject in the same way. Innervation is the same way. You have to know the information, the emergency of the infraorbital nerve, supraorbital nerve, dental nerve and the five lingual nerve. Very important, you know, to know all these branches and to see how we can provide, you know, innervation, vascularization, muscle, fat compartments. It's very important to know all these kind of places. And you can see we have to consider the superficial fat, median fat, and deep fat compartment. And especially when you're injecting on the periorbital zone, very important to inject deep into soft contact with the bone. We have to respect this kind of areas and to be very safe, you know, in our techniques. So anatomy and all this knowledge must be done. And we have a fantastic colleagues for that who make wonderful dissection and session for that. So you can see on different ways and in all session, very interesting studies for that. Here I pass very quickly, but I wanted to show you it's to respect all these fat pads, all these muscles, all this area, innervation, and all this way. Okay? Very important to respect that. We have to respect, of course, and to have this knowledge for that. We have to respect also the proportion of the skin, face and profile as well. You have a triangular face between the contus externe, the middle of the chin, and the corner of the commissures. Very important to respect this area, and very important to respect, you know, it can be square for male and more triangular for lady. We have to respect these weekend lines, you know, and the sternal lines here to respect, you know, the contact between the chin and the top of the neck, the nose. So very important to respect this proportion. As I told you, we can have male more square and ladies more oval or round face. So we have to respect that and to adapt, you know, this way of treatment. We also have this difference. It's why I wanted to show you how we can manage, you know, male and female to see that whenever it will be a little similar, we don't have the same eyebrow, we don't have the same projection of the face. And in fact, I think, especially for ladies, female, we work more on projection, volumizing, of course, but contouring also very important, especially on, you know, this cheek line over here. And we have to respect that and to respect this proportion. Okay, we have a projection which is very important to consider also the quality of the teeth of the patient and the projection. You have to keep, you know, a good distance between 2 and 3 millimeters from, you know, the lips and the contact with the canine as well. And very important to contact that. Okay, volumizing and lifting effect. How much and which technique? We have two medical approach or a surgical approach. Of course, the ideal goal, you know, is to get a good program for that. What we expect is to hide the wrinkles as much as we can. We hide, you know, and we fight against the marginal side. And we have to fight against, especially the shadow in the marionette fold over here, angle of the noise, infraorbital area, not on this slide, sorry. And we have to respect also the contouring and also the convexity of the face, so Steiner line, Ricketts line, and so on. Very important to get a good curving of all these areas and to be very satisfied also on correction of oval. A couple years ago, when we were injecting, we were working and rushing on nasolabial fold. Now, not so much. I work more, you know, on my oval, I correct more this area, I make contouring and lifting effect of all the face, and it's more interesting. Okay, what we want is to lift up the face, so we have to fight against the level of the glabella. Sometimes you have a deep wrinkle over here, a deep fold. We have to hide the eyebrow and to open the side of this periorbital zone, to correct the oval as well, to hide, you know, and the commissure of the lips and to diminish, you know, the marionette fold here and to lift up the cheeks. So it's already a good goal. When you have ladies, you are more curving and ovaling. And when you are ovaling, is not the real name, but it's very significant when I say it. and you are more angular for me. Okay? Entry points. I think we have to respect, as I told you, the facial artery is going up over here, going up, up level on the lips as well, it's going up here. Angular artery over here, supratrochlear over here. We have also the vein, who can sometimes go this way here. So we have to trace a line from the commissio to the tragus, and one from the internal canthus onto the angle of the triangular ligament. And we have an entry point here, very safe, that we are protected. With our cannula, you can go everywhere with fan technique, and we can use bolus injection or fan injection as much as you want, and it's very safe as well. With this product and with the upper line product, what I like, my entry points over here, I make 3 points, you know, on the zygomatic arch over here. Sometimes my third is a little upper over here. I want to lift up, you know, this cheek as well. Then I make one injection on the marionette fold and one in the angle of the mandibula. Like that, I stretch and I lift up all the face. Sometimes I can combine with one fighting against the shadow in the angle of the nose over here, and one near the tragus over here. And I like to use cannula in such case because I can slide with my cannula over here, because we have a risky point here with the facial artery, angular artery over here, and the angle of the nose here, it can be very bleeding, and we have to be very safe to avoid any embolization and any complication. Okay? To give you a volumization of a lifting effect as well, when you have this kind of patient, which is interesting, is to choose a good product and where we can inject as well. I use and I combine Apraline Forte and Apraline Normal, and you can see that it can be interesting with few points of bolus. Sometimes you can make bolus, sometimes you can use the cannula, whatever you want. And you can complete, you know, to complete this area. I made 1 point also on her, on the temple area, because she was quite empty in this area, and it was not very elegant. For ladies, when I make a projection of the chin, I make 1 point injection in the middle. For male, I make 2 points. I will show you after. Okay, that's to give you an idea. Here for the lips, angle of the commissure to help here. Sometimes I make with Forte fan technique over here, but I like to use, you know, normal at this area and to hide my commissure and to fill up the lips in the same way. We talk about it after that. Another patient, also lifting effect as well. You can see she also has an asymmetry of a noise. We can work as well. And I correct it with Forte, which is very interesting because we can correct oval. You can save, you know, the tension under the neck as well. You can lift up this area. We can correct the good balance of the noise. So it's very easy to use and very interesting. And usually I make 1 to 3 syringe for 1 full face. Okay, another patient. Different technique, as I show you, fan technique or bolus. If you make a bolus, you can make between 0.1 to 0.2 cc, and with cannula, I'm using cannula 25 gauge, 50 millimeter. Few examples, combining, you know, filler and meso to see a good lightening effect of the face and to see how we can provide the correct oval. And don't forget, make picture of your patient all the time. And very interesting for that to see how we can be very successful. Another patient here to show you. I combine, you know, meso. You remember I made a neck with a meso over here. I made an injection with Forte and Normal on all the face. Okay. Tips and tricks for lower face, and especially for chin and jawline. When we want to correct that, we have first work on the oval as well. You remember the lifting effect as we were presenting for that. I'm using needle 27 gauge cannula, 25 gauge 50 millimeter are very good. You can make two entry points, one point over here, one point on the chin, and you can make the full face, which is very interesting. And sometimes for here, I use hydro over it for the code bar. Pitching technique or injection. Usually for this kind of patient, two syringes of forte, two syringes of normal, and one syringe for the lips. Okay. Okay, femoral definition, as I told you, we work on the lower chin, and in such case, very interesting to stretch the skin in the same way. The major line and mandibular definition, that is typically for male, and very interesting. This one, you can see that he had a problem with a scar here. I injecting some meso product under the scar, and the cicatrization was much better, which means that meso can be stimulating for cicatrization, okay? And we complete injection with angular mandibular. Periorbital and perioral area first, sorry. We have to respect, you know, the different parts of the lips. We have plumbing effect, flat face, laces. So we have to respect that to work on the oral commissure. And usually there's an area I don't inject is this area on the upper lip here, because I don't want to overcorrect and to cover my my lower lip with the upper lip, because it's not, to my mind, elegant. Okay. You have to respect, you know, the bumping effect, the ridges, the bumping effect of the lower and the upper lip. I prefer to start to inject with the lower lip. But that is my opinion. After, you can be comfortable, you can choose. You can choose needle, you can choose the cannula. If you are using cannula, I think it's for volumating a lip. If you want to correct a contour and to draw a lip, it's better to use needles, to my mind. But that, it's I give you my techniques, after you can check. You have to respect, you know, this area. And when we talk about lips, of course we have to respect the lip as well, the commissure, the border, but we have to respect also the philtrum. The philtrum belongs to the lip. It's important when you inject a lip, you have to inject also the philtrum. It's anatomic, you have a junction of the muscle as well. Usually I don't inject too much in the valley of the philtrum, because when you work exactly, you draw the contour, you fill up the upper and the lower lip, is very efficace, and we can be very satisfying. What I'm doing first, I'm injecting sometimes this area, tac, for the upper lips and philtrum as well on retrotracé. For the lower lip, where I start, I make one injection, two injections, sometimes not in the middle because anatomy, we don't need too much. And then when I did that, sometimes when I want to volumate after that, I make one or two bolus in the upper lip over here, and one or two bolus in this quarter. And after, I make a good massage to mix, you know, to shake the salivary glands and the gel to have a good efficacy, because sometimes you can have a bumping effect and it's not comfortable for the patient. You can have a surgery technique, and that is a wonderful lifting lip made by one of our colleagues, Dr. Parang, which is fantastic, and you can see the result, face and profile. It's really amazing. And you can see that whenever we had a bleaching effect of treatment before, soon we finish the surgery. Whenever we made nothing else, we can be very successful. And you know, the whitening of the skin disappeared. That it's typically surgical, and I like very much his techniques. It's a really good practice. For the injection, you know, the lip, you can have different style of lip, so we have to respect the anatomy of the patient you have, and to draw, you know, and I repeat, very important, whenever you get a natural effect, you must consider injection, we say in 4D now, it's very in 4 dimension. It's important to respect, you know, the dynamic, because if you're injecting a place of a gel, And if you don't respect the dynamic, it will be ugly, it won't be, it will be unesthetic, and it will be a mistake. So we have to respect natural effect, dynamic effect. Very important. Okay? As a patient to show you same age, different style of lips, so you can see that we have to choose and to adapt. Another opportunity we can have, you know, to make a repair of a, to give you an idea, that is typically surgical when you have a loss of bone and you have a loss of teeth inside. If you are injecting this kind of patient without making any surgery in the mouth, you lose your time. What you have to do, very important, is to make scanner, to make a good analysis, to make a good surgery, to make bone graft, to make implants. I pass very quickly. Very important. And then you can see a result. If you don't make, it's why I wanted to show that, that is another case of Dr. Parent. It's absolutely fantastic because here we are very successful only because we work on the basement in the mouth. So start in the mouth, inject outside after. I think it's better to respect that. We could complete a treatment to make a small projection of a chin, but it's already a very good result. For that, we could make, you know, a good point in the middle of a chin. Okay? For male, this one needs more, you know, an orthodontic treatment, an osteotomy because of its progression. But before doing that, we start to make, you know, orthodontic treatment for him now. But I made one point, you know, with Forte, under, you know, the break, the labial break, under his philtrum over here, and 2 points on chin here, and I made the projection, you know, to be very efficient, but now we will work more on maxillofacial. It's more our domain, but I wanted to show you that. Okay, different techniques using cannula and needle. That is interesting to see how we can manage, you know, the treatment as well. Sorry. Okay, I have a small problem. Needle, the advantages is faster injection, is true. We can make a fewer manipulation. It's a very small treatment. We have a very small hole of injection. It can be more precise, but if we have a good experience, cannula is very precise as well. And we can more situate, you know, the deepness of our injection sometimes, especially when we are injecting in the soup, but in this area, especially I'm using more cannula, so it's not evident. Disadvantages as well, it's more risking, we can touch more nerve, blood, small capillaries, so we can have more hematoma, more inflammation, so, and sometimes risk of embolization and necrosis can be more important. Cannula advantages, flexibility, safety, that I think it's really evident, and all of us, I think, are using a lot of cannula now. We minimize the trauma to tissue. We have four holes we can inject in all the full face. It's very important. It's disadvantageous because it's more difficult to ending a little this cannula. You can have some more receptive risk if you are not very safe when you are entering in your hole. More expensive, but for my patient, I can tell you it's the same price. And I make an interest hole generally bigger than the cannula to be more comfortable to come inside. Okay? Cannula is preferred, you know, to protect, you know, the risk of neurovascular accident on the supraorbital area. Super orbital, suburb area orbital, chin area, top and nasal labial fold, in the side of the nose and near the nostril. Very interesting to see with the cannula. As a rule, more superficial injection with needle whenever you can go deep with the needle as well. Sometimes when I want to lift up here, I make 1 point with Forte, but 3 points exactly with 3 bodies. Of 0.1 to 0.2 each, and I make 1, 2, 3 bodies deep contact with my bone, and with needles sometimes I do that, and then I'm finishing with the cannula. Okay, calibre I'm choosing, you know, as I told you, 25 gauge, 50 millimeter, I think is the best. Because when you have a larger cannula, sometimes it depends the quantity and the thickness of the gel you are using. With Forte, 25 gauge is absolutely perfect. You can use it also 27, but I don't like so much because whenever we are very precise in our injection and so on, we can have a good, better distribution, it's true. It can be traumatic, and sometimes we can cross a capillary and so on. So a cannula can become a needle. So we must be very careful for that, okay? The needle, usually I'm using, depends on the area and the product I'm using, needle 27 or 40 gauge, whenever 22 gauge, especially on front head. And I like that very much, on the lips as well. And invisible needles are very, very thin. Sometimes I make small perpendicular points, you know, only to make a relief on our contour of the lip. It's very elegant. And these needles are absolutely fantastic for that. Cannula, as I told you, 27, but 7 to 50 millimeter. For me, sometimes I use 70 millimeter, but usually 50 is good as well. Entry point, you know it as well. Danger, risky point, never forget. Please think about that. Very important. And we have to say that. Of course, as we talk about knowledge of anatomy, how we can procedure to the technique, choose a good product, how we can manage different localization, how we can manage, you know, volumating, projection, contouring. It's important also to manage sometimes some complication we can have. As the fillers, as I told you, for mesotherapy, absolute contraindication, they are still the same. Relative contraindication, but I injected a lot of patients this way and never get any trouble. Once more, I touch wood. And we have to respect this anatomy, especially this sooth and this area on the tear trough over here. Very important to be very deep, contact with the bone. Never inject more than 0.5 on each side under the eye. It's better to undercorrect than to overcorrect. Remember that. Respect the angular artery over here. Very important, and to provide any embolization. So we have to respect all the grooves and the folds we can have, the trap, and to be efficient in our treatment. So we must inject, you know, contact with the bone in the sooth, and we make our bolus. If I inject with a cannula, I make one bolus from 0.1 to 0.5 each side. Or if I'm with a needle, I make 3 points of injection of 0.1 to 0.3 or 2. And I combine, and sometimes I make my needle a little curving, inclined of 45 degrees. Okay. We have one more, the wonderful slide from Dr. Ingalina for our dissection. And you can see that this area is very important to respect all the muscularization, the fat compartment, the artery, and to see exactly where we are injecting, okay? And you can notice that this area, it's very important to realize that we have a good, a lot of vascularization. So we must be very careful for that. It's why I appreciate more to use cannula. I feel more safety with the cannula than with needle. You can see the vein and the artery over here. So the safety area will be in the sooth, contact with the bone. If you are injecting with needle, change your needle from one side to the other one, because you, as you touch the bone, you can damage the top of the needle, and sometimes it's a little more sensitive for the patient. It's small details, but we have to respect that. The anatomy, you know it as well, so we have to respect that, and especially innervation and vascularization as well, and to respect the emergency of the infrabital nerve, especially for the periorbital area, okay? We have different difficult zones. We were not injecting at all before, but now we inject more and more. Temples area, and we have to close all the fissures and deepness. You got here in this area, when I want to be deep and to fill up the temple, I inject perpendicularly with one bolus, and I have contact with my bone. I make one big bolus, then massage, and so then it can be sensitive a few days, but it's good to say to the patient. Also, the tail of the eyebrow, I use normal and hydro. I make my enter points near the tail of the eyebrow over here, and I slide over my eyebrow, and I inject in this area. And you remember, as I told you, the botoxinia for meso is the same problem, same technique with hydro or normal. And I can high and open the site over here. Very interesting when you don't want to use a toxin, or when people or cannot support any toxin, or if they don't want it. Okay? And the long lasting is also very efficacious. Okay? Nasolacral and tear trap growth, you know, normal and hydro can be used as well. Don't be too superficial with forte when you're injecting this area, because remember, we must not create any Tyndall effect. In such case, it's not the product which is responsible, it will be our technique. So we must be very careful for that. Complication, we can have infection. In such case, we can treat with antiseptic antibiotic. Inflammation, corticotherapy. If it's a little painful, sometimes you can put ice before and after, and painkillers as well. And whenever you get a cystis or granulomas, you can use hyaluronidase. Risk of embolization, that we have a lot of presentation with different laboratories and wonderful colleagues for that. And I wanted only to be very global in the complication to tell you we can get necrosis, blindness, granulomas, Tyndall effect, that we have to avoid that and to correct and to treat all this area. The protocol, you know, complication, we have to manage fat with hyaluronidase, antibiotic, corticotherapy, local treatment, and psychological assistance. Very important, when you get any complication, be attentive, always contact, take photo, be all the time in contact with the patient, and very, attentive and present. Very, very, very important. I thank you very much for all the presentations.